Moscow.
Joining me now from New York is Rebecca Friedman-Lissner, Stanton Nuclear Security Fellow at the Council on Foreign Relations. One of the criticisms of Donald Trump when he was appointed president was nobody knew about his foreign policy. Do we think we know now what it is?
No, I still think we don't know what Trump's foreign policy is. Ever since he was elected, and indeed during the campaign, there were all kinds of debates amongst foreign policy experts about what would constitute the Trump doctrine. What would America first actually mean when put in practice as foreign policy? I think we are starting to see the emergence of a series of policies that could constitute a Trump doctrine, but the absence of an overall strategic framework still begs the question of what this administration is after when it comes to foreign policy.
You can understand why Russia, perhaps on his appointment when he was going on about America first, felt maybe he'd give them a break. It's not happening.
No, it's not. What I think you see playing out here is the tension between atmospherics and interests. There were really positive atmospherics during the campaign and up through some of the transition between Moscow and Washington. There was a clear desire on the part of both Putin and Trump to have a better relationship. But underlying that are some really conflicting interests. And now that the Trump administration is having to confront the conflicts of interest, you're seeing a real change in tone.
One of the interesting things, and we're just seeing pictures of Sergey Lavrov with Rex Tillerson, there in Lavrov you have one of the most experienced diplomats in the world. There's Rex Tillerson starting out in a new job, a new role, and the risk is that one runs rings around the other.
Absolutely. I think that's a serious concern. It's made all the more concerning by the divergent messages we've heard coming out of the administration. They certainly are not speaking with one voice when it comes to what they want when it comes to Syria, for example. And so that puts Rex Tillerson in a particularly difficult situation because there isn't a central guidance that he seems to be receiving in terms of what his message is in meeting with Lavrov.
Rebecca, what happened to all that optimism? You know, everybody thought we were going to have a new relationship with the United States and Russia, and here we are. Things have never been worse.
Yes, well, like I said, there was always this underlying tension because U.S. and Russian interests are fundamentally contradictory in many places. And this, of course, was always the question about what the Trump administration's Syria policy would be, because on the one hand, they sought cooperation with Russia in their fight against the Islamic State. But on the other hand, you know, there was this inevitable piece of the picture, which is Assad and Moscow's support for Assad. And those things were always in tension, and now the Trump administration has had to confront them perhaps sooner than they were ready to do. But, you know, those interests, you know, they're really not compatible. And that's the challenge that, you know, both Moscow and Washington find themselves facing.
President Trump has quite a challenge on several fronts, because alongside North Korea, I mean, this is a baptism of fire for the new president, isn't it?
That's absolutely true. And, you know, if anything, I would say that the North Korea threat is all the more alarming, even if it hasn't dominated headlines, at least for the past few days, given everything that's been happening in Syria. The Syria situation is certainly a humanitarian crisis. It does have bearing on American national interests and the interests of our allies, especially in Europe and the Middle East. But at the end of the day, from the U.S. national interest perspective, the much greater threat to the homeland and to our vital national security interests comes from North Korea. And, you know, the administration needs to keep its eye on that ball. And if it doesn't, it could evolve into a very dangerous situation.
Rebecca Friedman-Lissner, joining us there from New York.